that is something that we've heard down through history. For example, the Hopi Indians say that they've come up from four different levels below the earth. In other words, there's some subterranean regions there that normally human beings and animals can't penetrate. So there may be dimensions even to this earth that we're not able to penetrate, and perhaps some of these creatures enter and leave the world of our experience from these nearby regions.
Dimensional portals.
Right.
Mm-hmm. All right, east of the Rockies, you're on the air with Michael Cremo. Hello.
Hi, my name is Nick.
Yes, Nick.
In Rockton, Illinois.
Yes, Nick.
Well, Michael, I tend to disagree with you. I think it's obvious that evolution happened by itself. Look at dogs and cats, and what's a hyena? You know what I'm saying? There's no animal, there's no plant. I would say that plants and animals evolved from one being that I would call God. And
well,
our, I love
we might
show.
Not have a disagreement if we see what the process is. If you're talking about because I would agree with you that there's God at the top of the hierarchy, and there's a process of descent with modification by which from one generation to another, all the creatures that we're familiar with on this earth, including ourselves, have been produced. Now, but that's not the kind of evolution that you'll find described in the Bible. In the Darwinian textbooks.
Darwinian or the Bible. So it argues with both. And I take it, caller, you're uncomfortable with that.
Well, I'm looking at The Sex Contract right now by Helen E. Fisher. Have you read that?
I haven't. If you could tell me about it, I'd like to hear it.
Well, it's very informative. I like it a lot. It's kind of feminist view of how evolution went, but it's about sex as it went and how we evolved. But it basically what I think is that if you look at chimpanzees and gorillas and orangutans and the regions they are today, you would see that the orangutans are near Asians, and the chimpanzees tend to be more like white people and gorillas more like black people. And if you look at, say, Asians today and Indians, American Indians, and then look at Eskimos.
Well, I've never heard it quite suggested that way. That's very interesting. How would you respond to that, Michael, that there appears to be that connection to some of the major racial variations on the earth today?
Well, first of all, I don't accept that we have come from monkeys or orangutans or gorillas. The fossil evidence, the actual physical evidence that we document in our book, The Hidden History of the Human Race, shows that simply we've coexisted with these creatures for millions and millions of years. There's no physical evidence at all that we've evolved from them. So right from the start, I would have to respectfully disagree with the hypothesis being presented.
I am curious, Michael, see if you can answer this straight out.
Okay.
Do you find more fanatical resistance to your hypothetical, or I guess you could even suggest the evidence of the evolution of the human being, do you find more exception to it from the scientific or religious community?
It's very interesting that I've been finding that I've been able to go all over the world, and I have been. I've been able to make these presentations to... I've been on Christian radio shows and television radio shows, and I find they're very receptive to the fact that I disagree with Darwinian evolution.
Okay, the question again, from which camp do you think you find more stringent objection, scientific or religious?
The most objection I have been finding is from those who are in the mainstream scientific establishment. That is where the most opposition that I have encountered has been coming from.
I would imagine that would be true because at least your theories involve a concept of creation that the religious folks might be able to be more comfortable with than the scientific people. I see. All right. First time caller line. You're on the air with Michael Cremo. Hi.
Hi, this is Joe up in Reno.
Hi, Joe.
And it's a pleasure to call you, Art. I listen in every now and then whenever I can. And
Thank you.
I have a thought on this. The you know, we're electrochemical devices. We're perfect androids, biochemical computers, if you really look at us in a big picture.
Sure.
And the electro being the spirit, the android, the movement, the device that moves around is the chemical. Who knows where it goes in stores, maybe in the ozone layer or whatever, but you could see how things could be, spirits could be implanted or beings could come into us through something like that. It's a very tangible and logical way, and I wondered if Mr. Cremo had had any experience in dealing with it in that logic.
All right, it may be the last answer we have time for. Go ahead, Michael.
Yes, Joe, I think you mentioned something that's very important. It seems like if we want a good metaphor for the entire universe and our place in it, it may be like a virtual reality system on a computer.
Huh.
Now, if you know how those operate, that means you take somebody who's outside the computer and you hook up different devices to their senses, like you put little what they call iPhones over their eyes, small video monitors.
That's right.
So that they it creates the sense of being involved in the computer world, even though they're outside of it. So, in one sense, you could say that the person is being implanted into the virtual reality system inside the computer. So I think you're mentioning soul, and I think what we really are is we are souls who have been implanted by some system into the a virtual reality.
All right, that is where we're going to have to end it, Michael, very quickly because we're out of time. Where can they get your book?
The book is available by an 800 number, 1-800-443-3361. It's also available at Barnes & Noble and other book chains.
All right. Michael, it has been an absolute pleasure having you on the program.
Art, it's been a pleasure for me as well. Hope we get to talk again sometime.
Thank you, my friend. That's Michael Cremo and his version of the hidden history of the human race. To get a copy of this program, call 1-800-917-4278. That's 1-800-917-4278. Thank you all, and we'll see you again next Sunday at 7 Pacific time. From the high desert, good night, everybody.
This has been Dreamland, a program dedicated to an examination of areas in the human experience not easily nor neatly put in a box. Things seen at the edge of vision, awakening a part of the mind as yet not mapped. Yet things every bit as real as the air we breathe but don't see. Please join us again next week at this time for Dreamland.